Pakistan may be a country that is not quite up to snuff in terms of technological achievement like other countries such as America or other European countries, but it is one country that is known for having a rather impressive military presence. And because of all these factors, it hasn't kept Pakistan from bringing new technologies to the world that we know of today. And with that, we look specifically at Pakistan's CAC/PAC JF-17 multi-role fighter and learn everything we can about this aircraft. How's it going, everybody? What's up? My name is Dave Wapple, and welcome to FTD Facts, the channel where I look at people, cultures, places, and all that sort of jazz. And today we're talking about a very particular fighter, and I'm really excited to learn about this because this is like Pakistan's very own individual fighter. Now, this is kind of a sequel video to our last video where we looked at the JF-17 and we looked at the differences between that fighter and the HAL Tejas. And whether or not you feel one is better than the other doesn't really matter, because we're going to look at some great aspects of why this fighter was built and where it's going in the future. So let's get started, but before I do, just letting you know, there are some really cool playlists that you guys might want to check out. I'm going to put it in the description box below at the end and in the boxes for you guys to check out. And be sure to subscribe if you're liking this stuff and give it a thumbs up. So the JF-17 is a rather new fighter on the block, what the Pakistan Air Force describes as a 4th to 4th plus generation aircraft. This aircraft had its first real flight commencing on August 25th, 2003, in which a few years later it was introduced to the world on March 17th, 2007. Now, one of the reasons this fighter was created in the first place was because Pakistan wanted a new fighter that would eventually replace the Dassault Mirage 3 fighters that Pakistan had. These fighters had actually been in service for quite a long time, since about 1967, so Pakistan was like, yo, we need some new ones. However, the one thing that's really interesting about this aircraft is it wasn't just Pakistan that was really kind of doing it, although I do say it's like Pakistan's own real fighter. It was actually a partnership with China and somewhat even America. And before I jump into the history, one of the most unique facts is that this project was headed by one of the most prestigious fighter designers in China, and that was Yang Wei. Now, you may be wondering to yourself, why is it called the JF? Well, this stands for Joint Fighter. But however, in China, it's not called this, it's called the FC-1 Xilong, meaning Fighter China 1 Fierce Dragon. That's a pretty unique name. I think I like Fierce Dragon a little more than Joint Fighter. It just sounds so cool. So to back it up a bit, when it came to the development of this aircraft, one thing that they were aiming to do was have this aircraft do multiple things. In the JF-17, the type of aircraft it is good for is air interceptions, ground attack, and of course reconnaissance. Pakistan and China originally began developing this new type of aircraft, which they called the Super 7 Fighter. In the 1980s, the two countries actually split the bill for this fighter, coming in at around $500 million. But one really bad thing with the JF-17 is it has a rather disputed and, of course, long development history. There was a lot of ups and downs. This meant that there were a lot of delays within the aircraft, and that's why it took a very long time to make. I also want to mention one of the reasons for the JF-17's initial development was the fact that they wanted to have a fighter that could compete with the F-16s that were being made during that time. So piecing together some of the history, it starts back somewhere around 1987. Pakistan hired actually an American company called the Grumman Aerospace, which eventually led to a program which was called the Sabre 2 program. And this particular program included the countries of Pakistan, the United States, and of course the country of China. But shortly after that, there were a lot of sanctions that were put on Pakistan. The United States didn't really want to do a lot of business with the country. To add to that, there were also financial problems, and because of all these reasons, Pakistan had to force themselves out of this program. This resulted in the Sabre 2 program being left to only the US Grumman Company and China. But it really didn't end there, because shortly after that, China got in the bad books with the United States, partially because the Tiananmen incident that happened in 1989. This in turn ended up with the US cutting any technological sharing ties between China, and therefore the US company Grumman had to pull out. And that's one of the major reasons why the JF-17 took so long to make, was because of this Sabre 2 program, you know, being up and down and all over the place. However, by 1995, Pakistan had rejoined with China to make a new fighter, or at least upgrade one of the old ones. You could say that this theoretically was the Saber 2 program. The original concept was to make a major upgrade to the Chengdu 7 aircraft. But however, because of all the requirements, there were major changes in the design of the aircraft. And because of that, this Saber 2 program evolved into what is now known as the JF-17 program. And I won't lie, guys, this is the thing about the JF-17. There's not a lot of documented history on its actual development because it is all over the place. I'm sure if you went to the respected companies, you'd be able to find more about it. But there's a lot of controversy. People will probably even say that I'm wrong. I will probably say the same thing to other people that they're wrong. Now, one thing that is really well known is how China and Russia also kind of worked together to develop this fighter. The reason for this is because China ended up buying the designs and test data from Russia's unmade MiG-33 fighter in 1998. As a matter of fact, the engine of the JF-17 is known as the RD-33, which is made by the Russian company known as Klimov, and that is the same engine that is in the MiG-29, and the MiG-29 came from the development of the MiG-33. Now, some people will also know this fighter to be known as the Super 7 fighter. Again, that's another reason of the Saber 2 program and the Chengdu 7 aircraft. But for the longest time, until about 2003, the JF-17 was considered the Super 7 fighter until it got its name change. I also did find it very interesting that the original test for this was supposed to happen around that time. However, that got pushed back because of the SARS outbreak. Pretty interesting fact. For Pakistan, however, its first flight of prototype PT-01 was flown by pilots Rashid Habib and Mohammed Eshan Ul Haq. And in the early 2000s, although a major test hadn't been done at that time, Pakistan was already ordering about 200 of these aircrafts. And it was only a few years later that Pakistan received its first shipment, and it was first time unveiled to the public on Pakistan Day, which was on March 23rd, 2007. So here's the major question. What was the first squadron that had the JF-17? Well, these guys were called the Black Spiders. That is the coolest name ever. This first batch and first squadron was fully created on February 18th, 2010, and it was in that same year that they received 14 of these fighters, in which prior to that, the Black Spiders were flying the Nancheng A-5C. And this squadron operates out of the Peshawar Air Base, and for the first time the JF-17 was used in combat was during Operation Rai Najit, which began in South Waziristan in 2009 and 2010. In today's world, there are only three countries that operate the JF-17. There are others that do have interest in the fighter. These are the countries of, obviously, Pakistan. There's also Nigeria and Myanmar. They have 16 on order, and as of 2018, Myanmar has received 6 of them. Nigeria, however, has only ordered only 3 of these fighters. When it comes to variants, there's also realistically only 3 different versions. It seems like the JF-17 comes in 3s a lot. I don't know what it is. There is also considered a 4th if you include the 2-seater. Now, the 2-seaters have only been introduced into Pakistan in 2017. Now, these are used more for training and surveillance more than combat. But as for the main fighter, as I stated, you have 3. Now, they call them blocks, meaning that there is block 1, 2, and 3. As a matter of fact, the Block 2 version of this fighter gets a plus sign when it comes to it being the Generation Fighter. What I mean by that is the particular version that is classified as a Generation 4 Plus. And to give you an idea, Pakistan put an order for 50 of these fighters in 2017, soon to be delivered. Similar to the HAL Tejas, the first original, in which this is the Block 1 version of the JF-17, did not have the ability to refuel in the air, and that's been fixed for future versions. Now, let's take a look at some of the specifications. For that, we're going to look specifically at the Block 2 because this is the new standard. There is a Block 3, but it's kind of down the road. Basically, like all the main fighters, it is a crew of one with a length of 14.93 meters or 49 feet, a wingspan of 31.1 feet, and a height of 15.5 feet. Its maximum takeoff weight sits around 29,750 pounds. The Block II uses a Klimlov RD-93 afterburning turbofan, which makes the performance of this fighter go Mach 1.6. The service ceiling of this aircraft is 55,500 feet. And when it comes to armaments for this particular aircraft, you've got eight. You got a 1x23mm GSH-23 two-barrel cannon. For the hard points, you got two on the wing tips, four under the wing, and one under the fuselage coming in at seven. On the wing tips, you usually have your air-to-air missiles. These could be anything from the SD-10As to the PL-5E2s. You also have air-to-surface missiles, bombs, guided or unguided. It also can carry up to three external drop tanks and many countermeasures as well. In today's world, there are over 100 of these fighters that have been made since they started production in China in 2007 and in Pakistan in 2008. And like I said, the entire program cost for the JF-17 was anywhere between $500 to $550 million. And when it comes to the unit cost for the Block 1, it's roughly around $25 million. The Block 2, however, increases in price, coming in at approximately $28 million. And the planned Block 3 version, which not a lot of information is about that, except for maybe an upgraded engine and all that jazz, it comes in at $32 million. And that is just a rough estimate. As a matter of fact, when it comes to the Block 3, they got some major upgrades, especially when it comes to the radar, making it capable of tracking up to 15 targets and engaging 4 targets simultaneously. Since its introduction, the JF-17 has also accumulated over 19,000 hours of operational flight. And so far, it's turning out to be a rather remarkable aircraft for the country of Pakistan and its future buyers. So there you have it, guys. That is me looking at the JF-17. I hope you guys really like this video because, I mean, I tried to do as much digging as I possibly can about this fighter. Especially when it comes to the development. I mean, it's really tough to find information on that, but, you know, because so many people say this and then they say that. And so this is the best kind of accumulated knowledge that I could get from many different sources. So other than that, guys, my name is Dave Walpole. Again, be sure to check out those cool playlists that I got in the drop-down box up top, and of course in the description box below and at the end of this video. You guys will really, really like it, especially you guys from Pakistan. Got some cool Pakistan military playlists. So my name is Dave Walpole. See you guys later. Bye. Okay, guys. All right. So again, here you go. Here are those playlists. Check them out. Also, don't forget to leave a comment for a future suggestion for a video. And of course, don't forget to hit that like button if you really like this video and you want us to continue to do more of this type of content. But you guys have a good day. We'll see you later. Bye.